Position yourself in such a way that you can see what's going on, because what you might see is some very subtle stuff. Yeah, we might take that watch off if that's all right.
Ring as well?
Just the watch. It's all good. I'll sell it back to you later on.
Thanks.
My pleasure. So what I'm going to invite you to do is to just put your hand up on the table, just like that, and just allow your hand to relax there. Good stuff. And I'll come around and I'll sit. So that's why I'm just going to invite you to move around in such a way that you can see, because I might block you there. yeah, I think, are we recording up there too? Is that still recording? Is the... first of all, you have to ask Grace whether she's okay with being recorded. Okay, great, fantastic. So so what I'm going to invite you to do in a moment, but not just yet, is to imagine that your unconscious mind can communicate through that left hand. You do that? Can you imagine that happening automatically?
Yeah.
Can you imagine it happening automatically and there's nothing you can do to stop it from happening? Can you imagine that you forgot that you're imagining, for instance?
Okay.
Good, all right, fantastic. So there's nothing you need to do and there's nothing that you have to do. I'm just going to invite you to become an observer to your experience. And if something happens, it happens. And if nothing happens, that's fine as well. But you may feel something happening, but you may not realize, you know, it may not be so obvious to me. And you might realize that something's happening. You might get some little twitches and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And if that's the case, can you just let me know?
Okay.
Yeah. So we've been talking about the unconscious mind and so forth. And so what I'm going to invite your unconscious mind to do, if it will and if it may, is to play a little bit of a game with me. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Good. And so when I touch you on the side of the leg, I'm communicating with your unconscious mind. And when I'm talking to you, Grace, I'm talking to you. But I'm going to apologize, because I'm going to be a little bit rude. And I'm going to ignore you for a bit, because I'm interested in opening up a dialogue with your unconscious mind. And so what I'm going to invite your unconscious mind to do, if it will and if it may, is to play that little game with me. And if it will and if it may, I'm just going to invite it to just increase a signal through that hand, and to either, you know, twitch the finger or twitch the hand or move the hand. There we go. Ooh, very nice. And so what I'm going to invite it to do, and I'm going to thank it for its contribution and its willingness to play, I'm going to ask if the unconscious mind can increase the level of signal and increase the level of influence and control. And that's right, to begin to turn that hand towards your face in honest unconscious movements. I love the look on people's face when this happens. Here we go. Is that a movement that you've done, yourself consciously? No.
No.
So I'm going to ask your unconscious mind, if it will and if it may, is to just wave at Grace, just to say hello. That's it. And so what I'm going to invite it to do, if it will and if it may, is to turn that hand all the way around so that it's facing me. And so what I'm going to ask the unconscious mind, if it will and if it may, is to provide me with a response through that hand for a yes response. So just, oh, there we go. Okay, great. Thank you. And what I'm going to ask the unconscious mind to do is to provide me with a no response. Oh, there we go. All right. So did you see it was very subtle? It was just the little index finger. The little finger. So I'm just going to ask if it can provide me with a yes response. Good. And a no response. There we go. There it was again. Very, very subtle, but there nonetheless. And so what I'm going to invite the unconscious mind to do, if it will and if it may, is it willing, under these current conditions, to take Grace on a journey on the inside? Great. And so what I'm going to ask the unconscious mind, if it will and if it may, is to begin to do that now. And I'm not sure just when. It might just begin to close those eyes as things, that's right, start to shift and change. And I'm wondering whether the unconscious mind has got a sense that there's a place that it would like to take Grace to that's nice and pleasant. Thank you. And so if it can and if it will, to take it to a nice, pleasant place on the inside. That's right. To make that a nice, vivid experience on the inside. That's right. Wonderful, vivid, pleasant experience. So that you can see, hear, and feel all those wonderful, wonderful experiences. I'm wondering whether the unconscious mind can deepen that even more. That's right. Take her all the way in to that very pleasant experience as she dreams a dream on the inside. And to really increase the vividness of that experience and the wonderful sensations as her eyes move from left to right, right to left, and she dreams a dream on the inside vividly, and she can experience that fully and completely. And I'm going to request that the unconscious mind begins to lighten the right hand so that it floats up into the air all on its own. And the further up it floats, the deeper she can go. As it gets lighter and lighter and begins to lift and float and float and lift and drift upwards. And as it floats up, I'm going to invite the unconscious mind to take her even deeper down. Each movement up takes her deeper down, more relaxed. And intensifies the wonderful experience. Where she can really, and I mean really, enjoy that experience. In fact, the higher up that right hand goes, the more intense and pleasant that experience becomes. Enjoying every bit of that experience. The higher up it floats, the deeper she goes, the more she can enjoy that. That's right. Doing perfectly. And I'm wondering whether the unconscious mind has got another experience, a wonderful experience that she can experience on the inside. Thank you. Take her into that fully and completely so she can see what she sees, hear what she hears, feel what she feels, fully and completely. That wonderful, enjoyable experience. That's right. Really enjoying that as you see what you see, hear what you hear. And as that hand continues to rise up, you can go deeper down inside that and really feel that. Hear that, see it through your own eyes, through your ears, through your skin. Smelling and tasting all of the experience as well. As your unconscious mind takes you into that reality, and you can enjoy that as it continues to float up, up, up. And you float down deep into that experience. Doing perfectly. And I'm wondering whether there's a gift that the unconscious mind can give Grace. There we go, thank you. Something that she can take with her out of this experience. Thank you. And I'm wondering whether it's okay if we teach Grace how to go into this experience of hypnosis all on her own. Great. Fantastic. So in a moment, what I'm going to do is I'm going to count from 1 to 3, and on the completion of the count of 3, when I say the word sleep, Grace will instantly return to this very deep and profound place and state. This wonderful, wonderful experience. When I say the word sleep, she'll instantly drop down, instantly, quickly, easily, and effortlessly. When I say the word sleep, it just happens. It happens automatically. It happens automatically, and her unconscious mind can do that for her. Is that okay? Good. And so in a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 3. On the completion of the count of 3, eyes will open. You'll return to what is perceived to be a normal state of conscious awareness. You'll be able to talk to us, you'll be able to share with us what's been going on. And when I say the word sleep, you'll instantly drop down deeply, easily, and effortless into this experience. 1, 2, 3, that's right. Come back all the way, fully, yep. Oh, how's that? Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. What was that like on the inside?
Really nice.
Yeah.
Very relaxing.
Yeah. You don't have to share the content of it.
I'm happy to.
Oh, okay, if you like, yeah.
The first place I was taken to was walking along the beach with my partner and a dog that we look after quite frequently, which was really nice. We haven't done that in a while. We've been very busy, so that was very nice. And the other experience was us out camping in a pine forest.
And so when you were camping in the pine forest, what was present in your experience?
We were just hanging out at the campsite. It was nice and it was cool. It was fresh. You could feel the soil and the grass.
Amazing.
Yeah.
All that smell and...
Yeah.
Excellent. Very nice. Sleep. That's right. As I pick that hand up, you can just drop down deeper down again. All the way down. That's right. Nice and easily, deeply. Going back into that experience, enjoying that pleasant experience. Smelling the smell of those pine trees. Feeling the temperature on your skin. The warmth of the campfire and really experiencing that in all of its wonderful, wonderful glory. Enjoying the connection with you and your partner. A wonderful memory that you can draw on and remember and recall to re-experience that at any time you like in the future. And I did ask your unconscious mind if it was okay to teach you how to go back into this experience. And so I'm going to teach you how to go back into self-hypnosis, into a very deep and profound state of hypnosis anytime you like. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to touch your right hand. When I do, I'm just going to turn it over, just like this. And in a moment, when I count from one to three, on the completion of the count of three, you'll be able to open your eyes, you'll be able to talk to us and communicate with us and do all that sort of stuff. But what I'm going to teach you is that when you lift your index finger up and you say, sleep now, and then you lower that finger, that'll be a sign for your unconscious mind to take you back into this very deep and profound experience instantly, effortlessly, and automatically. When you lift that index finger up and you say, sleep now, and then you lower it down, that'll be a sign for your unconscious mind to take you down all the way, deeply, easily, and effortlessly. It'll be the same as if I go sleep and you just instantly drop down. For you, that will be your own way in which you go and access this very deep and profound state of hypnosis. When you lift that index finger up and then you lower it down, that'll be a sign for your unconscious mind to take you deeply, easily, and effortlessly all the way down and for you to sleep now. So, on the completion count of three, you'll come back to full waking awareness, you'll be able to talk to us, you'll be able to share with us, and you'll be able to do this all on your own. One, two, three, all the way back. That's it. Beautifully done, nicely. Wow, that was quick, wasn't it? Where'd you go?
Back
into the pine forest. Awesome, fantastic. So, what I'm going to invite you to do is to lift your index finger up. Yep. Say the word sleep now.
Sleep now.
That's right. Perfect. All the way down, deeply, easily and effortlessly. And so in a moment, I'm going to count from one to three. On the completion of the count of three, you'll come back to full waking awareness and you'll be able to once again communicate with us. This time, what I'm going to invite you to do is to say, sleep now for 30 seconds. And what that'll mean is that when you lift your index finger up and say, sleep now for 30 seconds, and then you lower your index finger down, that'll be a sign for your unconscious mind to take you into this experience or even deeper yet again. And after the completion of 30 seconds, and I'm not sure how your unconscious mind will know when 30 seconds is up, you'll just get a sense that 30 seconds will be up and you'll return to full waking awareness. There's lots of different ways in which your unconscious mind can track for 30 seconds. However, you'll just get a sense that it's time to come back into full waking awareness and you'll re-emerge and you'll reorientate yourself to the external world and return to full waking consciousness, knowing full well that when you lift your index finger up and you say sleep now, you can go instantly back into that experience. Or if I say sleep, you'll instantly go back into the experience. So on the completion of the count of three, you return to full waking awareness, you'll reorientate yourself externally to the outer world and feeling refreshed and relaxed. One, two, three. Oh, wow, that's it. Nicely done. There we go. That was pretty cool, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Did you know you had that skill?
No.
Well, you do now.
I do now.
There we go. So so what I'm going to invite you to do is to lift your index finger up. Yep. Say the same words, but just add the time frame of 30 seconds, right? So sleep now, 30 seconds.
Right. Sleep now for 30 seconds.
That's right, off you go. Great. Nicely done. How long did that feel for you?
I have no idea.
Okay. All right. How did you know that it was time to sort of come out of that experience?
Didn't think about it.
Yeah, it just happened, didn't it? Yeah. Yep. So that was about a minute. Okay.
Wow.
That's all right. That's all right. So this time, what I'm going to invite you to do is to say to yourself, sleep now for a minute. Lift your index finger up. And then when you lower it, that'll be a sign to go back into the experience. Your unconscious mind will get a sense of when a minute's up, and we'll bring you back out of that experience.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sleep now for a minute.
That's right, all the way down. Welcome back.
Thanks.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
So what you've learnt now is the skill of being able to put yourself into an altered state and to then bring yourself out after a certain amount of seconds or minutes. The time is arbitrary. However long you choose to be in that experience is really up to you. As long as you set a time frame, and you provide yourself with, in a sense, the suggestion to come back out of that experience. Yeah. So I'm not sure when now is the time for you to sleep. So isn't that a wonderful experience to be able to go deeply inside and to be able to take all these wonderful skills and gifts and to be able to integrate your learning in new and more useful ways, to be able to discard old strategies that no longer serve you and to be able to embrace new strategies that help refine your ability to acquire new skills, capabilities, and to access all of those wonderful gifts that you have on the inside. And your unconscious mind, that you have this wonderful, wonderful rapport with, this wonderful relationship with, can continue to support you and work in your interest and to look after you as you look after it, and as you continue to build an even more robust relationship with your unconscious mind, you might begin to discover just how easily you're able to learn NLP from the inside out, and how you begin to notice patterns and how you begin to notice patterns, not only in yourself, but also in others, that your unconscious mind can guide your attention in useful ways so that you can be the absolute best of yourself, the best version of yourself, to tap into your potential and to translate that potential into real performance, whatever you define that as. In whichever context you choose to apply your skills and knowledge and capabilities in. And it may be a point in time, sometime in the future, when you look back and just realize just how valuable this moment in time was for you and just how much things have changed for you for the better. And perhaps your unconscious mind knows how it can do that for you here now as you rest there in that chair, listening to the sound of my voice. And so in a moment, just like you did before, when you're ready and able to, or should I say when you're ready and willing to, come out of that experience, feeling refreshed, feeling relaxed, fully rejuvenated, orientating your attention externally in a way that's useful for you as you integrate all of your learnings and discoveries on the inside, only as quickly as it takes you to open those eyes and return to full alertness and awareness. That's right. Externally. That's right. Nicely done. Welcome back.
Thank you.
What a beautiful demonstration. Thank you.
I tried really hard.
Yeah. Nicely done. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Cool. So there we go. So interesting stuff, isn't it?
Awesome.
It's a skill. This stuff is innate in all of you. You all have this skill. And it's really about Grace trusting her own unconscious mind. And all of the stuff that you've just seen demonstrated here are just the applications of the principles of what you're going to learn over the program. It's just orientated towards a hypnotic experience, but dare I say, all experience is a type of hypnotic experience. That, you know, this is just a way into that experience and to tap into it. So hopefully you've got a little bit of an idea of, there's people who talk about the stuff, and then there's the stuff that can be facilitated. And you know, Grace was very, very kind to demonstrate her skill and capability in front of the room. But imagination is the key to the door. And you know, that was pretty cool with the hand, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Something that we'll be covering in chunk 7. The last chunk of prac, as you integrate all of your learning to be able to facilitate this. But this is impromptu, informal, can be done at a table, in a bar. You know, it's because people have always got this stuff at their disposal. It's about can you just do it? But it also highlights for you just how quickly people's state can change, and how quickly. What did you notice about your experience before I sort of say anything about what I observed? What did you notice about your experience and what changed for you as you went into that experience?
When I was under?
Yeah.
I never felt like I wasn't here in the room,
mm-hmm.
in front of a bunch of people.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, I was so happy to just relax and just chill out.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. And notice that it's an agreement that I've brokered with Grace's unconscious mind. I've asked whether it's okay to do this. I've asked whether it's willing to do this, and I've invited it to do it. It might seem like I've done it, but you've got to remember that I've got the agreement of the unconscious mind. Had it been a no, I would have respected that. So all I've simply done is I've swapped the pendulum for the hand. And what I'm asking is this all right? Is this a congruent, is this experience that it's congruent about facilitating, and is this something that it's willing to do for Grace, which is still you? But this is the whole thing, is that it's perceived to be as if it's something else, especially when people look at their hand and their hand is like this and they're going, oh, hello. And for it's almost like for the first time they meet their unconscious mind, and yet it's still you. But it's an interesting experience, and I love the look on people's faces when all of a sudden and I've seen video footage of people who just go, I don't even want to look at that. I've had people who do that. I know that it's waving at me, but I don't want to look at it. It's And in that moment, you're seeing the conscious mind going, who's driving the bus here? And it's consciousness. It's, in metaphysical thought, it's the illusion of separation. We are far more capable and far more powerful than we believe we are. And what I keep highlighting and keep saying is that you're far more than you think you are, because what you think is your thinking is often aligned with your conscious mind. That voice that you hear inside your head is often your conscious mind. And then there's other stuff that happens. So often what happens in this sort of experience, and I don't know whether you had the experience of hearing yourself talking about the experience. Did you hear any internal dialogue about, oh, that's a bit, oh, that's interesting. Ooh. Did you have any of that going on? I'm just guessing. But
yeah, I guess. Not so much as, it's interesting. It wasn't so much as physical thoughts, it's just awareness.
Awareness, yeah.
Yeah, I did have thoughts, though, when I heard people reacted going, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, they're laughing at me.
So there's this part of the awareness that's aware that something's going on.
Yeah.
And then there's this...
And I knew when you said, when you do the finger and you'll sleep, and I was like, okay, so it's, I'm going to do that next. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
So it's not like they're absent. It looks like that from the outside, but people are actively creating their experience but in a different way. They're an active participant in the process, and yet I've had people who, like Grace, have been able to just go into that experience, and they do it consistently. And yet, even though they are able to do it really, really consistently, they still doubt whether it'll work, which I find amazing. It's like, every time, every single time, it happens. And they're still going, I don't know whether it's going to work this. So the conscious mind doubts, but the unconscious mind does. And that's what I find really fascinating when there's that moment in time where they're going, oh, I don't know whether it's going to work. Yes, it will. because all of a sudden the unconscious mind runs a neurological strategy. It runs a strategy and it just knows where to go. So this is, in a sense, what I do generally in a first hypnosis session with people is I teach them how to do this. And then what I do is I go, great, you know, put yourself into the altered state and I'll provide some further facilitation. But it's very much self-directed, which makes my life easier because I'm a bit of a lazy hypnotist in that regard. And I always think that it's about them doing it. And if I can teach them to fish, then they can fish well for the rest of their life. And so, you know, when you think about, you don't need to go into these experiences for very long to get the benefits, to get the physiological benefits. I think about how profoundly relaxed you were.
Still am.
There you go. Some people pay a fortune for stress management, for meditation, to try and stop the internal thinking, the internal dialogue. It doesn't take much when you teach them and you then start to create a strategy with them to be able to have that anytime they like, when they like, provided that it's safe for them to do so. I wouldn't be doing this at all behind a car, behind the wheel of a car. If you're going to, so when people are doing driver reviver, for instance, I highly recommend that they get out of the car, they get into the passenger seat and they have their rest there, or they go into the back seat. That you keep your association with the driver's seat for an alert, externalized, highly vigilant state to pay attention to what's happening out there. So with things like driver reviver, if you're going to rest, then get out of the driver's seat and go into the back seat and do it there, because from there you're likely to be a passenger in a car anyway. You don't have to worry about where the vehicle's going, but you do if you're in the driver's seat. So by all means, don't do that there. And also, any time that you need to have full awareness for what you're doing, this wouldn't be the state that I would recommend. There's other states that you can build into this. Would you be interested in exploring some other things?
Yeah.
Awesome, great, fantastic. So just look at me here, sleep. That's right, all the way down. So you see some patterns here, don't you? Excellent, all the way down nice and deeply. And what I'm gonna invite your unconscious mind to do is to begin to create numbness in that hand, to make that hand so numb, so heavy, so relaxed. and numb, that hand no longer feels like it belongs to you. That it begins to just drop out of awareness as it becomes number and number. As if that hand's gone deep asleep, fast asleep, drops out of awareness. And in a moment, when I complete the count of three, the unconscious mind will keep that hand numb, and completely devoid of feeling for the time being. And it'll stay deeply in hypnosis, numb, heavy, out of awareness for the time being. And when you reach over and you touch it, that hand will feel as if it's gone deep asleep and numb. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. That's right. How does that hand feel? Reach over and touch it.
Like it's mine, but it's not quite.
Okay. Give it a good pinch. Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Amazing. Can you imagine that hand becoming numb?
This one?
Yeah. Could you imagine that hand, as it touches that hand, becoming number and number? Could you imagine it becoming like it's going deep into hypnosis and deep asleep as well? That's right. Isn't it interesting the quality of the hand just changed? Right? That it just... Isn't that interesting?
It is.
Is there an area of your body that you'd like to transfer that to?
I don't know.
What about your legs?
Okay.
So imagine that numbness traveling from there into the legs, and then becoming heavier and number. Imagine that numbness traveling up those arms into the body going deep asleep. And that's right, the head going deep. Oh, and relaxed. Achieving a sense of peace and relaxation. Feeling a deep and profound comfort. To the point that you just feel free and comfortable and relaxed. Perhaps experiencing a sense of comfort unlike anything you've experienced before, just a very, very free feeling of peace and tranquility and comfort, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. In a moment, on the completion of the count of five, you reorientate to the world, feeling refreshed, feeling renewed, feeling as if you've had an 8-hour sleep, 2-hour massage, feeling so relaxed, feeling so good. Every nerve, cell, muscle and fibre. Feeling as if it's been rejuvenated and refreshed. And you return to normal sensation. Your hand will return to normal sensation. Both hands, everything will return to normal sensation. Any feelings of anaesthesia that you used to have will be gone from your body. But what will be left is just this sense of complete comfort. Feeling good, feeling refreshed, feeling relaxed, exceptionally comfortable. Perhaps a feeling of relaxation, feeling of release unlike anything you've ever experienced before. So on the completion count of five, returning to what is alert, aware and normal sensation for you, yet feeling refreshed, relaxed, rejuvenated. One, starting to return. Two, starting to reorientate your attention from the inside to the outside. Three, feeling that cool breeze on your face as you start to return to the room. Four, fully coming out of hypnosis on the completion of the count of five, feeling refreshed, feeling relaxed, your hands, your arms, everything returning to normal shape, weight, shape and size. How's that?
Really nice.
It's pretty amazing, isn't it?
I felt like I was in a really cushioned armchair.
Notice all the little subtle things that people have as experiences in these experiences and the metaphors, right? Like being in a really cushy armchair, that's useful to store in your brain and useful for you to store in your brain as to what you could do to recreate that experience for yourself and to go back into the experience. We'll be playing a lot more with that stuff as we go through PRAC because people give you lots of information as to how they're structuring their subjective reality. So how's that?
Yeah, that hurts now.
Yeah. I always test it. You saw, didn't you? I really gave that a good tweak.
Yeah, it went white.
Yeah, I give it a good tweak. Some people even put their nails in, and there are some demonstrations where they put pins through the hand. I didn't do that, I promise you, to demonstrate it. But that's a little bit of a sideshow trick because once you go through there, it doesn't. So it looks amazing, but when you give people a good squeeze, and what I pay attention to is not whether they go, but whether their eyelids, whether the tension in their eyelids, you know, whether this goes on, because then I know that they're still getting sensation. So that's the difference, for instance, between anaesthesia and analgesia. There's a difference. Anaesthesia, it's at that point in time, potentially we could have done an incision. And suggestions could have been given for what we call vasoconstriction, which is reduction of blood flow. And you know, yesterday when we were looking at Surya and her face went white, that's vasoconstriction. When people flush, that's vasodilation. The blood comes into the comes to the surface of the skin. So at that point in time, under those conditions, potentially we could have done some surgery in that area, or acupuncture. This is what I keep highlighting to acupuncturists, is if you've got someone who's got a fear of needles or things like that, then when you demonstrate that they actually can change and alter their sensation, you've got the skill sets to facilitate that. They go, oh, that, I don't feel anything. It's great, fantastic, great, you can do your work. Or you can give them a set of trigger words and then just facilitate them from there and they can go into that experience and enjoy it. Dental work can be done. So there's a whole bunch of stuff. But notice that you touched that hand and then used your imagination to transfer it across to the other hand and then used your imagination to transfer it through to your legs. And then, because imagination is the key to the door. So thank you for another wonderful demonstration. I wasn't necessarily going to show you all that sort of stuff, but I think it's important that you at least have an understanding of why I keep saying what I'm saying, so that when I hold this perspective that it's because I've gone out there and tested this stuff and I see evidence like Grace is providing and I go, it alters your worldview and it's very different sitting on the outside of the experience as opposed to being on the inside of the experience. So as a allied health practitioner, potentially this now starts to have more relevance when you have an experience and go, oh my goodness, you know, that's pretty amazing. What happens when I start working with women, for instance, who are going through pregnancy? How can I increase their levels of comfort? Because in the later stages of their pregnancy, they become uncomfortable because the baby sits in funny positions, that they don't have to have a hard birthing process. They can have an easy labor. You can teach them to do this stuff. Why not? Pretty amazing. This is the innate potential. This is our birthright as human beings. This is what they mean by we have the internal resources. So when you behave as if they don't, that's your stuff. Because if you behave as if they do and you facilitate these experiences, amazing things can happen. Seeming miracles, magical stuff. And it's not magical, it's scientific, but it's also beyond the experience of most, but now your mental maps have expanded and this is the journey you're on. You swallowed the red pill the moment you signed up for this training. Maybe you realize just how deep the rabbit hole might go. But thank you.
Very welcome.
Yay!
Thank you.
How cool is that? Yeah, and now you can do this yourself. Mm. Yeah, absolutely. So
interesting to feel my eyes. I could feel that they were doing a lot of stuff.
Yeah. You see a lot of eye flutter, and you also start to see rapid eye movement. Mm. And that happens, and it happens quite quickly for some people. Some people you don't see so much, but yes, it's one of the first things that I did. Did you notice that I sort of noticed that? So these are patterns that I see, things that I pay attention to, and it's pretty. And did you notice the consistencies in some of the things like, and then the breathing shifts, the posture shifts? You see the similar patterns in behavior each time that indicates that this is the state. So this is what we pay attention to. We pay attention to the feedback and the behaviors and what's consistent. Yeah, nicely done.